Today, I'm going to bring to your attention some observations that you can make that will prove that evolution is not a principle of biology. Now, you don't have to have any deep understanding of biology or mathematics, and you certainly don't have to place your blind trust in the credentials of someone else. You can look at nature and understand for yourself the truth. Now, when I speak of evolution, I want to make it clear that I'm not referring to minor variations like you see in antibiotic resistance in bacteria or selective breeding of dogs. I'm talking about the gradual directional change resulting from added or fundamentally changed genetic information. For example, the gradual creation of a bird from a terrestrial dinosaur. This would have required the addition of millions of units of new genetic information. So is this possible? As I've shown in previous videos, it's not possible. And this is because a pattern of mutations with a predilection for specific genes would have needed to occur. And that is impossible by the central limits theorem. But what if you don't understand the math? You can still recognize that evolution is not a principle of biology. Now, I'm going to use one of my favorite examples, the proposed evolution of the whale. Whales supposedly descended from a land mammal about the size of a raccoon. This would have required thousands and thousands of fundamental changes. To make this simple, I'm going to only focus on one thing, the creation of a whale's tail from the tail of a land mammal. Modern whales and dolphins are claimed to have descended from land mammals with hooves similar to cattle. And the precursor's tail would have initially been useless in propulsion. So evolution requires the gradual improvement of a nearly useless tail to a tail capable of the acrobatics of a whale. Here's a typical imaginary depiction. This YouTube video has over 8 million views. And by the way, notice how the tail starts out with up and down undulations. This is false. All proposed candidates of whale evolution have side-to-side undulations of the tail. There is no conceivable way for a tail to gradually change from side-to-side to up-and-down motions. Now, this barrier is generally ignored because it can't be explained through gradual changes in anatomy. In any event, notice that as the creature is gradually transitioning, suddenly out of nowhere, tail flukes appear. This would not be the result of modification of a pre-existing tail, per se. This would require the creation of a new structure, that is, extensions of fibrous tissue in a specific location, specific orientation, specific shape, and specific microanatomy. Now, before I go any further, let me remind you of the central mechanism of evolution, random mutations plus natural selection plus time. And let me review four principles that you need to bear in mind. First, mutations are random. This means that if a mutation occurs, it's independent of the mutation that preceded it and the one that follows it. Now remember that a mutation is a random error in DNA replication. And since the DNA of a whale is composed of many hundreds of millions of nucleotides, this means that the chance of a mutation occurring and resulting in a tail that is altered in any way for swimming is one in billions. So if a mutation did occur that resulted in early modification of the whale's tail for swimming, that doesn't enhance the likelihood that another mutation will come along later to improve upon the earlier design. If you look at animals today, there are slight variations of traits. For example, if you lined up 100 whales today and measured their tails, they wouldn't all be exactly alike. However, bear in mind that these variations supposedly took millions of years to appear in the population. What I'm saying is that if a mutation did occur to create early tail flukes, variations of that trait would not suddenly appear in the population to allow for natural selection to improve upon that new trait and thus move in an onward and upward direction to a perfected tail. Now, another point, in that video I just showed, the tail flukes that suddenly sprouted could have occurred anywhere on the body. Why did they just happen to appear in the perfect location, the tip of the tail? For natural selection to work on random mutations, This suggests that there were millions of other locations that were tried, and these were culled out of the population so that in the end, natural selection could choose the best variations, the ones that occurred at the tip of the tail. Remember again, mutations are random. It's just as likely for a mutation to create flukes in the mid portion of the tail or some other location in the body as it is at the tip of the tail. If evolution is going to create a perfect tail, natural selection must weed out all the inferior versions. Yet all proposals of evolution show an imaginary pathway in which a trait appears in the optimal place, and then that structure is gradually modified. The next point, the environment doesn't prompt the appearance of a mutation. If Ambulocetus is spending more and more time in the water, that doesn't increase the chances of another mutation appearing to improve upon the tail for swimming. Remember the video I just showed. As the animal spent more and more time in the water, suddenly flukes sprouted. A mutation resulting in tail flukes is just as likely to appear in a rat or a baboon as it is in an animal that lives in the water. Now, it's often stated that whales attained a huge size because the ocean could support its weight. Again, living in the ocean doesn't increase the likelihood that mutations will appear to result in an increased size. Now, the third point, no characteristics acquired in life can be transmitted to offspring. In other words, the ocean doesn't directly shape the tail. So with these principles in mind, this means that there would have been millions and millions of inferior versions of design to result in the perfections that exist. So let's look at the end result. A whale's tail flukes are in the perfect location, tip of the tail, as opposed to any of thousands of other locations, in the perfect animal, an evolving marine mammal, the perfect orientation, horizontal, as opposed to many other possible orientations, the perfect shape, streamlined hydrofoil to maximize thrust and minimize drag, involving the right tissue, fibrous tissue, as opposed to cartilage or some other kind of tissue. The perfect microanatomy, organized layers of fibrous connective tissue in a specific orientation. So if you look at theories of whale evolution, whales are believed to have become fully aquatic in 8 million years. Now, if you consider the alleged population sizes, reproduction rates, and number of proposed generations, and then you calculate the number of possible variations of tail morphology, this means that in literally every generation of whale evolution, there would have been mutations in tail design that would have been visible. So here's a good question to ask an evolutionary biologist. If evolution is a biologic process, why do we not see evidence of this when we look at animals? Why don't we ever see an early dorsal fin starting to grow out of a dolphin's head or the body of a rat, for that matter? So with these principles in mind, consider how a whale could have evolved from a land mammal. With an understanding of this mechanism, you can logically predict that for evolution to be capable of achieving this level of perfection, you should see many, many trial and error versions of this in the offspring of living animals today. Now, evolutionary biologists might tell you that these variations exist, but that they're too small to see with the naked eye. If someone tells you this, ask for scientific evidence that this is true. Has anyone ever documented any inferior design of tail flukes in any location, in any animal, in any orientation, involving any tissue, even with the aid of a microscope? Now, be forewarned, if you present this kind of evidence to an evolutionary biologist, he'll change the subject. You'll be told that evolution of the whale has been documented through the fossil record or through looking at molecular homology or embryology. Don't fall for this. These are all failed arguments that I've addressed in other videos. If evolution is a true principle, it would predict that these variations that I'm referring to would be abundant in numerous species, and they are universally absent. Now, I've only discussed one feature, the whale's tail. In reality, one would expect innumerable evidences of trial and errors in multiple systems to believe that a random trial and error process could explain the origin of any complexity. Thank you for tuning in. I appreciate your support, and I hope you'll subscribe to my channel.